What's up? It's me, Kai. This is round number 4 in the Legacy Showcase qualifier. And we are on the play. That last round was weird. I gotta tell you that much. Yeah, it was weird. I don't think we drew. Nothing came together, it seems. Yeah, let's don't cast. Let's don't cast Preordain. You might need 4 force. Mox Diamond, okay. Like, one thing I'm super happy about is that we haven't... I thought that this event's gonna be like Mono Delva, and it really isn't. Which is super, super nice. Because I, like, before this event, I had a lot of thoughts about, like, maybe I'm supposed to, like, switch my deck or, like, play Red myself. Or, like, some Jeskai deck or, what do I know, like you know, something along those lines, right? And, yeah, I think I made, like, even though we are 1 and 2, which is not particularly exciting, I still think we made the correct deck choice. And this is like, I'm playing against regular depths here. Could also be playing lands. Probably lands. I'm gonna force a Will of Crop Rotation if they have it, and probably let everything else resolve. So, yeah, I think I'm gonna force that. Okay, so let's see. They even got rid of their wasteland, which is kind of nice. Let's see. We are most likely going for an Ideas Unbound pile with forcible backup. Or maybe not. Maybe no. Let's skip on the forcible. We don't need that. But we need Rotus Petal instead. We need a little more mana. So 1, 3, 4. So with this pile, we beat one wasteland. Yeah, sounds good. And we also have Pact of Negation backup. I dig it. Yeah. Unless... I think it's fine. We won't use any of our cards in hand. But that would probably, hopefully not... change the outcome of this game. Next turn we are gonna cast a decent bound draw and fetch the volcanic island, draw everything we have, and yeah, have packed up, and like they already crop rotted away their wasteland, and like even if they have a wasteland here or like a port, I don't mind. Do they have? Life and Loam, sure. What's that mean? You got it. You got it. Okay, and going through the motions here. Looks like this is plain lands, this is not deaths. Against lands, what I... it's kind of funny because Cavern of Souls is indeed a powerful card against lands. Cards I don't like this matchup, so are probably the discard spells. I do like Force of Negations quite a bit because they do counter Sphere of Resistance. I also do like Personal Tutor. Excuse me. So cards I don't like are base is somewhat weak, especially on the draw. So I think taking out three discard spells and one duress, three discard spells in the days for three force of negations and one person tutor, is fairly reasonable. We bump up our counter count to 10, and we also gain a little more speed. Hopefully we have, oh wow, perfect. Look at that. We have lands, we have a counter, we have doomsday, perfect. It's slow, but that's fine. Like, you don't need to be that fast. Like, as long as we have those lands secured, and like, look at this. Like, this is all fetch lands. It's awesome. Okay, so we are wasteland proof. Doomsday is gonna hopefully resolve off three underground seas here. Yes, I'd like to keep. Opponent also kept 7. Tiger, exploration, sure. Usasaga, I don't particularly care about Usasaga. Wow, look at that. Lotus Petal, even better. I think I'm supposed to play out Lotus Petal now, because if they play Sphere of Resistance next turn, that'd be kind of awkward with Lotus Petal. Okay. What do you got? I will... Ooh, they're good. They played... They didn't, okay. They didn't have Thespian stage. Interesting. I mean, I am gonna... 100% gonna... Doomsday here. They cannot even make a construct. Like, Dark Depths doesn't even tip for... Like mana, so for any mana. And this also plays through Mindbreak Trap. I don't think they can counter this. Ooh, they do have a crop rotation. Interesting. So what can why do they crop rot in response to Doomsday? Sure, I mean I can't stop it anyway, but like I'm kind of curious what their plan is. Like, do they wanna Wajuka bog me so I can't get Lotus Petal back, or do they wanna wasteland? Okay. But like, why did they do that in response to Doomsday? Like, now I know that I have to play around wasteland. Maybe one day we'll find out. So what about this here? So we do. Oh no, I kind of like Pact of Negation, if to be honest here. Let's see. So next turn we could play Flooded Strand or Volcanic Island. We can't counter Endurance. Maybe, you know what? Let's don't take the Cavern of Souls. Let's take Pact of Negation instead. That way we can beat either Red Blast or Endurance. That's better. And we also empty our library. But this way we lose to double wasteland. So maybe I'm supposed to put in Cavern too. It's gonna be slow though. I wonder if I really want this. It was probably too slow. So what about two fetchable lands? Oracle Pact of Negation, Edge of Autumn. Yeah, this is probably a little better. Okay. Like this, we have to pass twice, but like given that our opponent can't, like even now, like he can make a construct, but then he has to pass on the wasteland. It's kind of awkward. Yeah, okay, well there you go. Yeah. Opponent didn't even make a construct token. It was kind of awkward, right? Like the start with crop rotting away the dark depths for a wasteland in response to Doomsday. Hey, there's Mox Diamond. They got, oh wow, they discarded another wasteland. Okay, what is happening? Choke. No, thank you. If they have Rep Lost, I can daze that. Kind of funny. And it looks like, yeah, it looks like that's exactly the case. Okay, it's all coming together. Now that I only have one card in hand, and our top card is Darkest Oracle. So we should probably just win the game here. 3-2, yeah. Okay, and this is round 4 of the Legacy Showcase Qualifier. Thank you so much for watching.